Right now, state troopers are investigating a law enforcer who slammed into a homeless man on a bike and killed him. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sigalski. The Florida Highway Patrol says the Melbourne police officer hit the bicyclist on the way to a call a little after 9:30 last night on State Road 518. Troopers say the biker rode into his path. WESH 2's Michelle Meredith is live in Brevard County. Michelle, investigators say the officer's lights and sirens were not activated.
That's right. They tell us he was running on the kind of call where they do not turn their lights and sirens on. Now, according to Florida Highway Patrol, the Melbourne police officer was responding to a call heading east on State Road 518 when he hit a man riding a bicycle near the intersection of Bluebird Boulevard. FHP says the man on the bike pulled out in front of the officer. The victim, 53-year-old Richard Hill, was taken to the hospital but died of his injuries. This is what is left of his bike and belongings. Friends tell us he was homeless. The accident happened at 9:40 Thursday night. Why was the officer running without lights and sirens? Melbourne police say the officer was responding to a theft in a house with a possible disturbance. Police say this is not the kind of call they run lights and sirens on.
Although a theft with a possible disturbance is important that we get there as quickly as possible, it didn't warrant that emergency response with the lights and siren activated.
Do you think that would have helped if they were on?
That's unknown to me. Again, I don't really have the facts that led up to the crash itself. Lights and siren are designed to give us more visibility when we are responding to emergencies, but at the same time, we don't respond to every call with those lights and sirens on.
Sergeant! Now, the officer is on administrative leave pending the outcome of the traffic homicide investigation. Live in Brevard County, Michelle Meredith, WESH 2 News.